You know, I've always said that people in America get divorced too soon because you should never get divorced until you have no unfinished emotional business. Really, you should get divorced when you're not pissed off anymore, you're not hurt anymore. I mean, because that means you've done it all. You've turned over every rock. You've looked, you've gotten it all out, and now you've just said, you know what? We're done here. I can wish you the best. You can wish me the best. But people don't do that. They still have emotional agendas, and then they run those agendas, and the kids get caught in the crossfire, right? And in this case, wow. You just have to set up a timeline and look at when people do the things they do. Timing is very, very important. And if right before a big custody hearing, one side or the other makes an allegation that the other one is abusing the child physically, mentally, emotionally, sexually, having been trained as a forensic psychologist and worked in the court system for many, many years, I always watched that timing. Like a year would go by, and the week before a hearing, an allegation comes up. I go, come on. And then if a parent says, I think that this parent over here, the other, my ex-spouse, is abusing the child, but I'll let him come pick him up the next day. Now, come on. Would you, for one second, as a parent, if you thought your ex was abusing a child, say, yeah, you can pick him up at 7?
No.
Not one chance in hell would you do that. That's why I came back and said, I'm going to tell you the truth. Do you think nobody had ever sat her down and told her the truth until today? I think sometimes you get in a system and you just become a number and nobody cares enough to tell you the truth. Somebody needs sometimes to set people down and say, you're lying, nobody believes you, stop blaming, stop being the victim, get your together and do what you have to do or you're never going to have your child back ever. Somebody needs to tell people that. Get through them and tell them that, or they'll never see their child again. Now, she may walk away saying, that is the biggest in the world. And that's fine. I'm not looking for a new best friend. But if I get through to her, if she hears me, it can save her relationship with her son. She needs to stop blaming, stop being a victim, and own what she's doing. And ask yourself, if you're in situations like that in your life, where you're blaming people, where you're, you know, you just don't like the situation, so you're spinning it and trying to blame people, put on your victim hat. My dad used to say, you should spend 5% of your time deciding whether you got a good deal or a bad deal, and 95% of your time deciding what the hell you're going to do about it. And that's how I was raised. Take 5% of your time and say, okay, is this fair or not fair? But when that 5%'s up, you better spend another 95% saying, good or bad, what the hell are you going to do about it? Because you're the only one that's going to dig yourself out. And that's what I was trying to tell her.